Hi, thank you for listening. This is my first gun rights video. I don't usually talk about gun rights, but I've seen this video, Guns with History. Oh, the way they go about it is extremely annoying, you know. There's a certain group in America who are trying to ban guns. They want to do away with the Second Amendment, basically, or make changes to it. Rather than just go about it the correct way, you know. Make a new amendment, get most of the states to agree to it, cancelling out the second, done. They know they're not going to be successful doing that, so they have to try and use different tactics. The main one is manipulation, you know. Somebody please think of the children. Oh, and those other first class citizens, women. So let's go through this bullshit, right? It actually has a voice actor from Grand Theft Auto 5, Michael, but we'll call him Fredo in this one. I don't really care about that kind of shit, you know, when an actor plays a part with someone with guns and then complains about guns, because when they're playing the part, they're just an actor, they're just doing a job. I don't hold them to any like standard there. I don't expect them to go, "Well, I'm not taking that part. There's a gun in that film," so I don't really care about that. But let's go through the bullshit and you'll see what I mean. Here, it starts off like this. So over 60% of Americans think owning a gun will make their life safer. Yes, and that over 60% of Americans would be correct. In fact, owning a gun increases the risk of homicide, suicide, and unintentional death. By a small amount. Owning a gun doesn't increase the risk of suicide. I don't own a gun. If I wanted to commit suicide, there are many means of doing so. If I wanted to commit homicide, I don't own a gun, but there are many means of doing so. I've got hammers. I have work tools. I have knives, you know, ropes, you know, and my bare fucking hands. So owning a gun doesn't make a difference to me. I can still do those things if I really want to. An unintentional death. I could slip and fall down the fucking stairs and kill myself. I could walk into a fucking door and knock myself out, fall back and land on something sharp, dead. All many different things can happen, not just with a gun. God's sake. So all of these could apply to a fucking hammer or a piece of rope. Owning a piece of rope, you know, it increases the risk of homicide, suicide, and unintentional death. For God's sake. To make first-time gun buyers think twice, we did the unthinkable. The unthinkable. Now, what could that be now? We opened a gun shop in New York City. Was expecting something actually unthinkable. With hundreds of guns, all of them with a history. Hidden cameras captured the gun buyers' reactions. Yes, hidden cameras captured the actors. Sorry, gun buyers' reactions. And here are some of these actors. Sorry, gun buyers' reactions, you know. And just think, this could be you buying a gun. And this could be you getting your mind changed on the Second Amendment, which keeps you and your family and your protection safe from fucking criminals.
You're interested in a gun, right?
Oh, yes.
Okay, cool. You looking for something for what, target practice or?
Protection.
More for just protection.
Just safety.
I'm pro Second Amendment, you know, so it's like, it's kind of hard to find that around in here.
He's pro Second Amendment. That actor, gun buyer, sorry, he's been put in there to make you think, well, I'm pro Second Amendment as well. And if this man can change his mind, I could be as cool as him and I could change my mind too. On the fucking amendment that keeps me safe.
City, you know, it's
yeah, like I was showing your wife, you know, the first gun I showed her was this revolver. It's the easiest gun we have to use. It's you know, it's our most popular one. It's this 22 caliber 6-inch revolver. It's
so you were showing his wife that, and he was standing right there and didn't even see you doing that.
Also, a gun that a 5-year-old found in his parents' bedroom, went down and shot his 9-month-old baby brother with it.
That is tragic. It's tragic that, well, a lot of things are tragic in this story. There's a young baby and there's a 5-year-old. The parents in that household did not keep that gun in a safe place away from where a 5-year-old could get their fucking hands on it, right? And then the 5-year-old tragically shot and killed the baby, right? That's a tragic story. Of course it's tragic. But is it the gun's fault? Is it the Second Amendment's fault? Or is it, as I would suggest, the fucking parents' fault? Were you not watching your five-year-old? For fuck's sake. Did you not have your eyes on your five-year-old? What were they doing? How did you not know where they were? Why did you not put a gun out of their fucking reach? You fucking maniacs.
When it says shooter, five-year-old kid, dead one, what is that?
That's the history.
This is the gun that the guy shot.
That's the gun.
This is the one? This is the one that the kid used?
Yes, holy shit, this is the one that the kid used. Are you feeling emotional yet? Are you feeling against guns yet? You know, because a kid used a gun that should have been out of its reach because their parents were incompetent, not because of the Second Amendment. The kid did not use the gun because of the Second Amendment. My God, this government are doing, in America, they're doing everything they can to make the citizens of America not able to protect themselves. Think about the children. The children. Next.
Can't take this shit back after you do it.
This is a 9mm semi-automatic. It's a very handy gun. It's easy to use. Carry it in a purse like that gal from the Walmart. 2-year-old son reaches into her pocketbook, pulls it out, shoots her. Dead, gone, no mom.
Yes, dead, gone, no mom. Very, very sad tale. Tears are streaming down my face. But didn't she have it on safety? I mean, couldn't she have had it in a holster that was hard to open for a child? I mean, come on, man. Why was she leaving her gun within reach of her fucking child, though? Seriously? For God's sake. What if this child was near, in the reach of a knife? He or she could have stabbed her mum. Gone. No mum. Sad. Let's ban knives, right? Fucking hell. Again, not the amendment's fault. Incompetent mother's fault.
Collectors love this one. Adam Lanza's mom had this in her collection too. Till he took this and several other guns and killed her and went down to Sandy Hook, killed 6 teachers and 20 innocent children.
Mm-hmm. That we're no longer allowed to talk about because it didn't fucking happen. That's a different video, but come on, Sandy Hook, seriously? Are we going to go there? Are we going to go to the story that didn't even fucking happen?
20 little kids. Gone. Like that.
Aye, they were gone just like that. So were the fucking parents when the press tried to fucking interview them. They no longer exist. Christ.
You walked into a McDonald's.
Again, even if it did happen, which it didn't, but even if it did happen, not the Second Amendment's fault. It's not the Second Amendment's fault that people are allowed to protect themselves. Imagine if the teachers in that Sandy Hook shooting that didn't happen were allowed to carry guns with them. You know, maybe it wouldn't have happened, which it didn't.
McDonald's in San Diego killed 21 and injured 19. It's one of the deadliest mass shootings in American history.
Yes, and that guy looks all sad, doesn't he? But just because a maniac shoots 20 people and injures 19, that doesn't mean regular, normal people in America shouldn't be allowed to defend themselves, their families, and their fucking possessions, and their home, and their property. God's sake, you're not even making a case at all. You're just telling us sob stories, expecting everybody to go, oh my God, aren't guns terrible? I'd sure hate to be one of those gun owners.
They thought, ironically, that they were protecting their 9-month-old. She thought she was protecting her 2-year-old.
And none of these people as well are saying, excuse me, I'm in here to buy a gun. I'm not in here to hear your fucking sob story. Can you... Tell me more about the gun. I'm not interested in your fucking sob stories. None of them are saying that. None of them at all. Imagine they went in to buy a watch and they done this shit. You know, this watch was once worn by a fucking serial killer. I'm not fucking... Whoa! I don't care what kind of watch Jeffrey Dahmer wore. Is the watch a good watch, for fuck's sake?
9mm semi-automatic. 40 caliber compact. 45 caliber. 9mm submachine gun.
I'll have two.
12-gauge pump-action shotgun. Why don't you have a closer look?
Oh my God, that was used in that shooting that didn't even fucking happen. Oh my fucking God, that's shocking. But even if it was used in the shooting that didn't take place, why? What's the point? What is the point? Madman does something mad, right? I mean, the madman could have easily done something mad with a fucking knife. For God's sake. They enter the store looking for their first gun. This is how they left.
Pretty blindsided by just the entire history of every gun in the store.
I know, because you went in to buy a gun and this numpty's telling you all about the history of certain guns that were used. That's not what you went in for. But you're not going to buy one anymore. Well done. You and your family are now defenseless against criminals. Well done. Next.
And it made me actually think I'm not going to buy that gun.
Yes, maybe you should think you're not going to buy that gun, which leaves you and your family defenseless. Well done.
It made me think twice and I would not buy one.
Well done, now you and your family are defenseless against criminals who would are willing to do you harm. Well done, congratulations, here's a badge.
It is one of our rights, but...
Yes, it is one of your rights.
But...
One of your rights that you should be defending to the fucking hilt.
My opinion has definitely changed. I don't feel safe with a gun.
Well, you won't feel safe without one once, five guys kick your fucking door down and come in to fucking rape you and kill your children. You're not going to feel any fucking safer without one, are you?
You don't want to be the Walmart case.
You don't get to choose if some madman goes mad. You just don't. But maybe, if you don't want to be the Walmart case, maybe get a fucking permit to carry a concealed weapon. Then you can at least put a fucking stop to it. God. Every gun has a history. Let's not repeat it. Find out if a gun will make your life safer at gunswithhistory.com. Or, no thanks. I'd rather not go to a website sponsored by the current government in order to change the Second Amendment or abolish it completely. But this Guns with History thing, and they're all sad tales. I don't want to be one of those nasty gun owners. Oh my God, that could be my child. Oh my God. I mean, what if I get a gun and put it within reach of my 6-year-old fucking son? I'm not allowed guns in my country anyway. But what if I did? You know, who's to blame? The rule that states I'm allowed to have a gun? My son? Or me for being so fucking stupid as to leave it somewhere where he can get his hands on it and not leaving it in on safety and not leaving it in fucking like a gun cabinet or something like that? Oh no, it'd be the rules' fault. It'd be the rules' fault for allowing me to have it. Well, I also have at my disposal some interesting stories about guns with history. Would you like to hear them, kids? Here's one.
All right, you have to look at one of the most amazing pieces of surveillance video we've seen in a long, long time. Let's call it Granny's Got a Gun. Take a look. This is a bunch of gang members storming into a jewelry store in Garden Grove, California. They just rush in there, but seconds later, you'll see them hurrying. Shots are fired right there. That's because the woman behind the counter opened fire. And these guys, they just booked it out of there. You can see them crowding by the door right there. They're just getting out as fast as they humanly can.
Look at the way these gangsters, they go into this shop to rob this jewelry shop. Five of them, all armed. But the woman who has the right to protect herself and her property uses her Second Amendment rights and starts firing shots at them. Look at how they react to this. They absolutely shit their pants, five of them, and they do everything they can to get out of that shop.
The getaway car. They're running fast. That's what happens when you give a grandmother a gun. Police say the suspects were picked up about a block away.
Oh my goodness, that is some funny video.
That is a funny video. And it shows us five of them, one driving the car, five in the store. They all had guns, but the woman, the old woman in the shop, also had a right to defend her property thanks to the Second Amendment. And those guys were not able to rob her, not able to shoot her, not able to do any more damage and not see through their criminal act. Thank you to the Second Amendment. I think we should all give the Second Amendment a round of applause for that one, because that's why she was able to do that. And you notice how they reacted? This is what you anti-gun idiots need to fucking understand. This is how criminals react when they're faced with a gun. When they're faced with the Second Amendment right in their fucking face, that's how they react. There was five of them against one woman, and they all ran like fucking cockroaches with a light turned on. They scarpered, shat themselves. Shit, we might actually get hurt here. Yes, you might. But the anti-gun people, the anti-gun lobby, They don't want that woman to have the right to protect herself. They want her to get shot. They want her to be a victim of robbery and who knows what else after they've been robbed. Here's another interesting story of a gun with history.
The beer guy is walking out of the drive-thru, but as soon as he did, I saw the guy coming with the gun.
The owner of a carryout in Elyria faces a struggle of life and death when a would-be robber tries to force his way through a door to the cash register of the store. The man eventually succeeds in getting through the door, but the owner has a surprise for him, a gun she carries in her hip pocket.
I reacted as fast as I could to shut the door to get a barrier between him and I, and he starts busting through the door. He makes it through, and as soon as I see him, I shot him.
Once the tables have been turned on the bandit, he makes a mad dash for safety.
But you see again, once again, the criminal is faced with the Second Amendment rights the owner of the property has, and look how the criminal reacts. They shit their pants and they run away. This is why the Second Amendment is one of the greatest things in America.
Away from the store and the gun-toting owner. She does not want to be identified, but says her store had been held up earlier this month, and she was acting on instinct when she fired at the suspect.
It was, you're not getting me, this ain't happening to me again, this is, I'm not going to allow you to take this from me, and basically it was survival. I was trying not to get killed.
Exactly. She was trying not to get killed. And thanks to the Second Amendment, she didn't get killed. And the robber, who was kicking the door and, I'm going to get the cash you have in here, I'm going to take your property and I'll probably kill you as well. There's a very good chance I'll kill you because I've got a gun, which may be illegal, by the way, which is easy to get when guns are illegal. But then, as soon as he realised, shit, she's using her Second Amendment rights, he ran away with shit in his pants, unable to see through his crime. Or finish off his crime. Here's another interesting story about a gun with history.
Well, this is a rare story. It's unusual in that it's a frightening reflection of life in cities today. But it's also inspiring because in this case, the victim turned the tables really fast. Almost every call is urgent in the Richmond Police Department's dispatch center, but few are as memorable as this one from last Sunday night.
I need to come to you guys. Yeah.
Okay, what's going on there?
Because somebody took in my house and I got up in a hurry.
The call came from the home of 84-year-old Gustava Harvey, who lives alone. That intruder kicked down her door and made directly for her bedroom. But there, Mrs. Harvey had a surprise for him, a vintage 38 caliber police special.
Fired one time, and in the straight direction that he was standing, the bullet struck the wall at about chest level. So he was very lucky not to be injured or killed by that.
It took just that one shot for the intruder to leave, and in a hurry. Mrs. Harvey and her son did not want to relive the experience today.
Thanks to the Second Amendment, that 84-year-old woman who lives by herself was able to defend herself from God knows what that man would have done to her. But thanks to the right she had to have that gun, bang, guy runs away. Again, the criminal scarpers. This is what happens when you have the right to protect yourself, that you people want to take away from her. You want her to be vulnerable. You want her to be a victim of crime because you do not want her to have the right to defend herself. Oh, but we just mean people who have a criminal record shouldn't have a gun. Well, she's got a criminal record. She's got unpaid parking tickets from the 90s, and she's got a criminal record. She dropped a bit of litter once in the 80s. She's got a criminal record. She went through a bout of depression once. So if you're going to do this mental illness shit as well, she went through a bout of depression once. She had mental illness, and she has bipolar. There. Should she not be allowed to defend her home, herself, and her property? No. Is that her family? No. No.
The surveillance video captures it all. Four suspects, armed and dangerous, attempting to invade his southwest side home.
The victim was able to get back inside his house, close his door, semi-barricade it, reach for a weapon that was easily accessible.
That's when you hear gunfire. The four men retreat, get into their car, but not before the homeowner's bullets hit the windshield.
Look at the reaction.
Sheriff's officials say the homeowner has surveillance cameras installed all around his house.
Well, you see the reaction? Four guys with big guns try to do a home invasion. One man with gun frightens them off because he takes shots at them. And look at the way they run. They absolutely shit themselves. This is why the Second Amendment is great. It makes criminals shit their pants. Here's another interesting story about a gun with history.
Police say multiple suspects broke into this home. And then the owner, who neighbors say is a correctional officer, came home.
Just sitting there watching TV, they said, and then we heard like 5-6 bangs.
According to police, the homeowner shot and killed one and possibly injured another.
That does make you nervous. Like I said, it'd be nice if everybody get back to work and, you know, kids ain't out on the road looking for money and whatever.
You never know what's going to happen. You got a lot of gang activity going on here.
But family members of the suspect shot and killed paint a much different picture of their loved one. They say 21-year-old Christopher Childress didn't involve himself with gang activity.
He might not have involved himself in gang activity, but he broke into someone's home and got shot for it. He shouldn't have been breaking into someone's home, because that someone has the Second Amendment on their side and they have the right to fucking shoot him for doing so. He should have fucking known that. He deserves everything he gets. I don't go into people's homes uninvited. It's called breaking and entering. There's a good chance you'll get done in.
And that he stayed out of trouble.
And these are the people we're now supposed to believe that this guy was a fucking good guy. Listen, look at these two cunts.
He's always been a good person here as of late. He might have done a couple of things just to make by as far.
He might have done a couple of things. What do you mean he might have? He's a good person, but he might have done a couple of things. You mean crimes? That's what you mean, right? This cunt. Are we supposed to believe this cunt here?
As far as I know, he's not been involved in no bad behavior before. So, I mean, this is the first to me.
Oh, God. Here's another tale of a gun with history.
Showing two gentlemen some jewelry and a gun pointed in my face. Guy saying, move or I'll kill you. My brain turned the tables around and I went on from defense, I went on to offense. Went, got my pistol, returned fire. A gentleman in the black shot him in the chest, but he was wearing a bulletproof vest. The gentleman in the white shot him in the chest. Both are armed. Both are violent felons. There's no way that thugs can walk the great streets of America and get over on a Marine.
But again, as you can see, these are violent thugs, violent criminals, two of them. One remarkably looks like Puff Daddy, or P. Diddy, or whatever his name is this week. And the guy takes shots at them, and he's got a bulletproof vest on. He still hits the deck and crawls away like a frightened dog, desperate to get out of that shop, because the shop owner has the Second Amendment on their side.
The guy that you see now in the white, he winds up dying 2.5 years later, and the other fella wearing the black is doing 15 to 20 years in prison as a three-time loser.
So, as you can see there, there are cases, plenty of cases, of people using their Second Amendment rights to protect themselves. But, I'm not going to stop there, because there's far more, and I'll go through these very quickly, right? Just to show you that it's not all about kids accidentally picking up guns that their parents were fucking stupid enough to leave within their reach. It's not just about that, or mad people doing mad things, which they could easily have done with hammers and fucking saws and you know, drills and fucking knives, easily. Here's some more, right? Great tales about guns with history, if we're going to go down that fucking road. This one. Police. Woman shot intruder 9 times in self-defence. An intruder who was shot and killed after a confrontation with a Duluth woman in her shower was likely stalking her for days and may have other victims. Gwinnett police said, school counsellor shoots and kills home intruder. The 53-year-old woman, who is also a veteran private school counsellor, was alone at the time of the Wednesday morning attack. She lives on East Mount Tabor Circle in Duluth. The woman was getting out of the shower when she was met by a strange man with a kitchen knife. Police said, they said there was a struggle in the bathroom. You see how he can use a knife to commit a crime? They said there was a struggle in the bathroom and she fell in the tub. Police later identified the man as Israel Perez Puentes, a Cuban national who lived in Alpharetta. The male was armed with a kitchen knife. A struggle ensued between the two of them. She fell in the bathtub, injuring herself. Police spokesman Edwin Ritter said, The woman tried to fight the man off with a shower rod, and he forced her into her bedroom, police said. They said she told her attacker she had money in the room, but she grabbed a 22 caliber handgun and shot the man 9 times, police said. Gwyneth said the man ran out of the back door and collapsed in the yard. He later died at the Gwyneth Medical Center. The victim, who was injured in the scuffle, was also taken to the hospital for treatment of non-life-threatening injuries. Police have not released her name. So there's another gun with history. That history being the woman's able to defend herself from her knife-wielding attacker by shooting him 9 times, and now he's dead. Now he can't do that to anyone else, thanks to the Second Amendment. Armed off-duty cop prevents mass shooting in San Antonio. Gunfire erupted at the Mayan Palace Theater on Southwest Military Sunday night, just before 9:30 p.m. This shooting comes just days after a deadly rampage at a school in Connecticut and sparks memories of the mass slaying at a movie theater in Aurora. An armed off-duty deputy working security was able to take down the shooter before he could kill anyone. Another gun with history there. Here's another one. 82-year-old Oregon man defends home, shoots intruder. 82-year-old Salem, Oregon resident John Rose shot an intruder who broke into his home during the early morning hours of October the 8th. According to Portland's KATU, the break-in occurred around 6:15 a.m. and when Rose and his 83-year-old wife, Mamie, were in the house, Rose shot and wounded the intruder, whom Police Sergeant Chris Baldridge says should survive. Baldridge said the suspect appeared to be under the influence of drugs and alcohol. Police have not been able to identify the suspect, but he will face burglary and trespassing charges once he is released from the hospital. And who knows what else he might have done if he wasn't shot, thanks to the Second Amendment. Here's another one. Homeowner shoots intruder in Walton County. There were frightening moments for a Loganville family forced to fight back against a robber chasing them in their own home Friday afternoon. A mum and her twin 9-year-old children tried hiding near the attic, but the crook wouldn't back down. Police say the crook was armed with a crowbar and the terrified woman inside the home opened fire on the crook, striking him 5 times. Investigators say Paul Lee Slater is in critical condition and in an intensive care unit at Gwinnett Medical Center in Lawrenceville. Cops said Slater used a crowbar to bust open the front door, and when he heard the woman call out to her children, he gave chase. Investigators said Slater then chased the family into a crawl space near the attic, and when he opened the door, the mother opened fire, striking him 5 times. Good for her. Police said Slater stumbled out of the house, got into a car, and crashed into a tree line in an apparent getaway attempt. And these gun lobby idiots, they would want that woman and her daughters to be vulnerable to that man's attacks. They're the real scum, by the way. Stay put or I'll shoot. Woman warns girl's assailant. Here's another story of a gun with history. Monica Jones said Thursday she was more angry than afraid when she rushed to the aid of a screaming neighbour girl, pointed a shotgun at a man who had allegedly ripped off the youngster's clothes, and warned, "Stay put or I'll shoot." "You don't think about getting hurt," Miss Jones, a mother of three, said in an interview. "If someone is getting hurt, I can't close my door." Police credit Miss Jones' quick reaction with preventing the 12-year-old girl from being raped. "She's a heroine," said Police Captain Robert Richters. "She did an outstanding job, simply outstanding, but Miss Jones, 28, said her actions under the circumstances were only normal. I was going to stand back and let the, I wasn't going to stand back and let this man take this child and do awful things to her," she said. "She wasn't nothing but a baby. If she were my child, I would hope somebody would be there to save her." Police said the victim was grabbed at a bus stop in North St. Louis about 7 p.m. Tuesday and dragged into the apartment building where Miss Jones lives with her three children. The man ripped off the girl's clothing and tried to rape her, but the girl managed to break loose and run into the hallway where she was met by Miss Jones. "I was talking on the telephone when I heard screams. I cracked my door and I saw this child butt naked and him half clothed. I screamed at him to let her go. He told me to go away. She was screaming, 'Please help me.' I asked her how old she was. She said she was 12. I knew I had to do something. He was beating the devil out of that little girl." At that point, Miss Jones told her son to get her single-barrel shotgun. She pointed it at the attacker as he tried to drag the girl into his apartment. He tried to run off, she said. "I told him not to go anywhere." Again, that young girl could have been raped, and that woman, God knows what would have happened to her. She might have got beaten and raped, or killed and raped. but thanks to the Second Amendment, she was able to fend this man off and keep him there until the police got there and arrested him. In another one, 14-year-old boy shoots armed intruder in home. According to the Associated Press, a 14-year-old Phoenix boy shot an armed intruder who broke into his home at approximately 4:30 p.m. Saturday, June 23rd. At that time, the boy was babysitting his younger siblings, aged 8, 12 and 12. The incident started with a woman ringing the doorbell to the residence. Since the boy didn't recognise the woman, he refused to open the door. A short time later, the boy heard a loud bang, which he correctly assumed was someone attempting to force entry through the door. The boy gathered his siblings and hurried them upstairs as he armed himself with a handgun from his parents' bedroom. From the top of the stairs, the boy saw a man break open the front door. When the man pointed a gun at the boy shot the man. The man did not fire his weapon. The man was subsequently transported to a local hospital in extremely critical condition. Since the shooting, the man's status has been upgraded to critical, and he is expected to survive. The man, whose identity has been withheld, can look forward to being booked into jail on charges of aggravated assault and burglary. The woman who rang the doorbell remains at large. And another one. When guns stopped a massacre, on February 12, 2007, a lone gunman, Sulejman Talovic, opened fire at the crowded Trolley Square shopping mall, killing five bystanders, armed with a shotgun and a pistol grip, a 38 caliber handgun and rubber grips, and a backpack full of ammunition. He set forth on his rampage through the mall, but he did not get far. He did not get as far as he had hoped. He was stopped when off-duty police officer Kenneth Hammond of the Ogden City Police Department, who was at Trolley Square having an early Valentine's Day dinner with his pregnant wife, when they heard shots, she called 911 and he drew his weapon and confronted Talovic. He was joined by Sergeant Andrew Oblid of the Salt Lake City Police Department. They pinned down Talovic, stopped further deaths until a SWAT team from Salt Lake City Police Department killed him. Hammond, a man with a weapon, was credited with saving countless lives. Again, countless lives being saved thanks to the Second Amendment. Another one. Teen shot at Atlanta school, student held, armed guard disarmed student suspected of wounding 14-year-old boy in courtyard of middle school. A 14-year-old student was shot at an Atlanta middle school Thursday afternoon and another student was taken into custody, police said. An armed guard disarmed the shooter moments after the 1:50 p.m. shooting in a courtyard at the Price Middleton School in southeast Atlanta. The teen was shot in the back of the head, but the wound was apparently not life-threatening, authorities said. Atlanta Public School Public Information Officer Steve Alford said the teen's wound was more towards the back of the neck. Atlanta School Superintendent Errol Davis said at a late afternoon conference that the youth's family, had reported that he was conscious and talking at Grady Memorial Hospital. The hospital said he was discharged Thursday night. An armed off-duty Atlanta cop officer who works at the school subdued the shooter and had him drop his weapon, Police Chief George Toomer said. Several shots were fired. He did not identify the gun. Turner said the two students apparently knew each other, but he did not discuss a motive for the attack. And as you can see, there are many instances of the Second Amendment being pretty useful and people having guns being very, very helpful and preventing themselves from getting killed, injured, raped, robbed, and their families possibly being killed, raped, robbed, or anything like that. But you anti-gun nutters would prefer to see people defenseless. Oh, but we just mean people with severe mental disorders. And then that way, you don't have to attack the Second Amendment. You just have to attack the mental health industry and say, right, count that as a mental illness. Count that as a mental illness. And count that as well. People that swear, count that as a mental illness. That way, everybody can't have a fucking gun anymore and protect their homes, themselves, and their families, thanks to you lot. You scum lot who do not... Not only do you not appreciate the Second Amendment, which you fucking should because it keeps you alive and safe, but you also don't respect it enough to tackle it in the right way. You'd rather tackle it by making people feel guilty. Oh my God, right in the feels. A child. Let's ban guns rather than do it the correct way. Create a new amendment that cancels out the second. Get most of the states, the majority, vast majority of the states to agree to this amendment and then you'll get what you want. If you can't do it that way, then you can't do it. Fucking hell. I'm not even American. I'm not even in America. And I know this shit. Anyway, I've went on long enough. But I had to show examples of where guns are useful. I'm tired of this nonsense, but guns are, they lead to, there's more chance of homicide, same with a hammer, there's more chance of suicide, same with a knife, same with a rope, you know, there's more chance of this, there's more chance of that. Oh, please, fucking please, there's also more chance of protecting yourself and making criminals, as you've seen in those videos I showed, making criminals shit their pants and run away like fucking cockroaches that they are. Isn't that fun watching them do that? Yo, man. Yo, I got two guns here and I'm going to rob you. No, you're not. Bang. And they run. They run and they shit themselves. They did not see it coming. It's brilliant watching them shit themselves like that. Anyway, as I say, I've spoke long enough, so I will leave it there for now. Thank you very much for listening, taking the time to listen. 35 minutes. Jesus. Thank you very much for listening. Until next time.